Hi, my name's Chris Monsour, and I was a teacher at sea 3 summers ago. I was aboard the Oscar Alton SETI. I got to spend a month out in the Hawaiian Islands doing research. Basically, I was doing a lobster survey and working a little bit with the gray-tipped reef sharks. And what was interesting about my trip is that we got a little diverted and actually got to go all the way out to Midway Island. I had the experience of going on to Midway and spending 2 nights there and getting to see some of the albatrosses, and got to go out to Lisianski Island and see some of the monk seals. So overall, my experience was great. I was pretty flexible. I didn't have a set amount of time. I told them I'd go wherever, whenever, and for however long. So like I said, I left June 15th, got back July 15th, and I would go back in a minute. In high school, I teach AP Bio, I teach Anatomy and Physiology, and I also teach a 10th grade Advanced Biology. And then I also teach Microbiology at a community college and Environmental Science at a community college. So I've been able to use my teacher at sea experience in almost all my classes in one way or another. Some of the things I would suggest for people who are going to be going on a trip is you have to be flexible. If you go in with this mindset that, you know, everything has to be perfect and on time, it doesn't always work that way. You have to be flexible because, you know, if the weather changes, something happens on the boat, you just got to kind of roll with the punches. Take some stuff from home that kind of, you know, reminds you home, like take a pillow or something that's going to remind you if you do get homesick. I never got homesick. I was glad to get out of there, not going to lie. But 30 days did add up after a while. And just kind of another big thing is try to keep up on your logs. You have to post logs every couple days. And if you don't do that for a while, sometimes they'll catch up. And so it's just good to, I always took a journal, and every night before I went to bed, I would jot down my thoughts for the day. I kept a journal of all the animals I saw. So I would think of ideas how I could incorporate what I did into my lesson plans. Some of my lesson plans I did a lot with marine ecology. And so as I was developing my lesson plans, I tried to go back to my journal and think about, okay, on this day we collected so many of this type of fish, or we collected so many of this type of lobster. And I would try to use those visuals from my actual experience in the lesson plan. I got to talk about the impact of invasive species in the Northwest Hawaiian Marine Sanctuary, because we also have a problem with invasive species in Lake Erie. So I was able to tie that into my classroom. Also, when you're developing your lesson plans, you do want to keep them science, so you want to use a lot of the data. The scientist that I was on board with supplied me with all his data, so I was able to incorporate that into my lesson plans. What's good about the experience is inquiry, so you can use your experiences in inquiry-based lessons. Other things that you may want to do is make sure you tie your lesson plans to the national standards, because these lesson plans are sometimes posted, and if teachers from other states want to use the lesson plans, you want to have them tied into the national standards. You may also want to relate them back to your state standards too. And so, but there's a lot, this experience gives you a lot of new data and new information that you can use in the classroom. Also, by using the online resources that NOAA has, you can, pretty much it's endless in what you can do with your lesson plans. Like I said, for the last 3 years, I've been very active in the Teacher at Sea program as an alumni. It's been a great experience, and I'm just glad that I had the opportunity to do it.